Hello, I'm Seamus Connery from the Sean Connery Space Program. We're highly trained professionals, so please do not try any of this that you're about to see at home. Ever.
Space. The final frontier. I've conquered many mediums before. Bodybuilding, modeling, television, film, and women. There's only one thing left in the world that I haven't had the chance to conquer. Space. Here at the Sean Connery Space Program, we have the most state-of-the-art equipment. A crack team of rocket scientists.
Holy crap!
An ace recovery team. And most importantly, a flair for adventure. This is our most ambitious launch ever. We've decided that we're going to fly to the outer reaches of our very own solar system. We're going to try to put a probe in Uranus. One of the biggest dangers of probing Uranus are the horrible conditions at the surface. They're also very angry and very Uranus.
One of the most important things we must consider when sending a probe to Uranus is making the rocket and other equipment a very brilliant color so that you can see it against all the surroundings you have behind you. However, Mr. Connery has absolutely insisted that it be completely and solid white, like Snow White, so that it blends in with the polar bear's natural environment. Mr. Connery does not want to disturb the polar bears of Uranus.
We've traveled to the cotton fields of East Reykjavik for a desolate area to launch our rocket. The cotton fields of East Reykjavik is our favorite launch area. It's quite a desolate area. There aren't many people that live nearby. There's one small village that I've purchased here with my own money and I installed a very large tavern there because, well, I can't help it, I'm Scottish and I love to drink. We launched our most famous rocket at the cotton fields of East Reykjavik. You may have heard of it. It was called the Chrome Dome. I named it after my father. The old geezer didn't have very much hair. For Scotland!
Sean should be coming any minute.
I think I see him.
What was that?
I don't know.
Channel 10 News here. As you can see, we have found an unusually small rocket. It seems to be a rocket that some kids launched off somewhere. As we move on, you can see people in the background are discussing why someone was on this tragic rocket when it exploded. We cannot, now, as you join us, we will come in closer to see why these people are arguing.
I tell him, don't use white rocket in snow, you can't find it. That's why he's Roger Explode. We're not gonna find him tonight. We have to give up. He got eaten by polar bears.
Man, I hope we can find him.
Mom, we had to give up Sarge tonight. He was polar bears were coming out. Maybe the Nessie got him.
Yeah, I read something in my literature or science book that said polar bears do live in snow in harsh winters.
Harsh my ass, they live in winters anywhere. I tell him not to use White Rocket. White Rocket hard to find in the snow.
Yes, and I think something else said messed him up too. They used a streamer and not a parachute.
I tell him, you're not James Bond in real life. You're Sean Connery, not James Bond. James Bond movie.
Well, that may be true, but he still was James Bond in the movies.
Whatever, he crazy man. He only do listen to the radies. He never listen to me. I tell him, you listen to me. You're gonna live long.
Yes, I saw him before he launched with a strange, glowing, green alien woman.
I tell him, you not listen to those alien ladies. They bad, bad news. That's what he get for trying to go to her with her anus.
What do you know about this explosion that happened in your own very backyard?
I know that crazy Connery fellow. He decided he wanted to go out in the field and set off a rocket. I told him them damn polar bears are out there and they're gonna get him. But no, he didn't listen to me. We think the extra weight he added onto the rocket caused it to explode into one of the lagoons.
Well, we just hope the dreaded Nessie sea monster does not get him before the polar bears do.
Yeah, I know that's gonna be a mess to clean up.
We hope it is a big one.
Chief, everything's on fire again.
Fire, oh geez, you know what, Newsy, we gotta let you go. We gotta go put out this fire before it burns down the tavern.
Okay, Fire Chief Don. This is Channel 10, signing off. Hey, man.
Hey.
Have you heard about Sean?
Yeah, it's bad news.
I know, man. I'm really gonna miss him.
He was a good kid.
Kid? He was 89 years old.
Well, he's a kid to me, anyway.
Well, he wasn't a kid on that rocket. Well, he blew up like a marshmallow.
He was always with young women, I don't know. Kid, whatever. But he loved his rockets, you have that right.
I think he painted an alien woman on his rocket.
I thought it was all white. That's why they couldn't find the thing.
Hey, cameraman, you like my shirt?
Yeah, that looks really cool.
Thank you.
tell him, no, paint that rocket white. You can't find that rocket in the light. I tell him, don't paint that rocket white. You can't find it in the woods like this. It's not all snow. Them polar bears, they come and they're going to eat him.
Polar bears? Let's get that gun.
I tell him, don't paint that rocket white. You can't find that rocket in the snow. Those polar bears, they're gonna eat him.
Polar bears, let's get the gun.
Stupid Frenchman!
Hey, let's go find that Frenchman. I wanna shoot him. Are we going mining? Ron, get back here! You need to finish your homework!